Allow me to explain to you the tragic failures of the outdoor Christmas lights over the many years of trying to basically just make a smart controller in a weatherproof housing, which this is not. This company Wemo makes some good stuff, and I want an outdoor light controller, but I do not want to use some weird third-party brand that requires another app, another access to Wi-Fi. Wemo currently makes an outdoor controller, but the reviews are mixed, and the fact is it's backordered until January, and the fact is that's after Christmas. I need Christmas lights now. Now, what I've had for years is a couple of these things. These are available at your local home store, big box center. It's a controller that has a photocell, but there's a tragic flaw, and that is that the photocell's behind this piece of plastic. Water gets in behind the plastic, destroys the photocell, and then the whole unit becomes absolute crap, and it's no good anymore. This one is better. It's made by Intermatic, but it's a timer that is a timer. It doesn't use a photocell, and because the light changes due to the solar cycle, this is unreliable. Pain in the butt. You gotta get out there and set it and forget it and then go back and remember you have it. And the most annoying thing is that the cord, when you go to plug it in, the whole thing hangs upside down in your electrical outlet, exposing the power cord. This is a poorly designed piece of material. They should have put the cord coming out of the top, not the bottom. It's got some holes in the back, whatever. I'm not drilling holes to mount this thing to my house. Dumb. I'm not going to smash that on the ground because that's still good. Put that over there on the pile. By the way, since smashing this on the floor, you can't smell this through the camera, but this smells completely burnt, and it's worrisome that it's completely burnt. It smells terrible. It smells like burnt transistors, which is never good for something that's supposed to control 120 volts AC safely. So let's fix the problem. Yeah, let's fix it. By the way, if the company's watching who made this thing, the CDS cell, which is the light sensor, is corroded. The corrosion got to the inside of this module. There's some white corrosion that moisture and electronics do not mix, people. All you had to do was just put this behind some type of better sealed plastic and this thing would last forever. But instead it's just crap. And I don't want any more crap in my life, so I'm making my own. By the way, full disclosure, none of this is really like kosher in terms of electrical code or electrical safety. I'm only just using my own wit here. I'm just being reasonable with electronics. If you try this at home and it burns your house down, like, please don't turn around and sue me because, like, you did something wrong or cheap or whatever. I'm just saying, like, we live in a litigious society, and I mean no harm here. I'm just trying to control my Christmas lights with my phone. Like, really, it's 2020. It's been beat up enough. Thanks. So you're going to need a few things here to make this work. You need a Wemo controller if you're using Wemo. You could use whatever brand you want if you got Amazon or whatever. It'll just work with anything. I'm using an Apache rugged mobility case from Harbor Freight. Very inexpensive, quality unit, good enough for the girls we date. I also picked up one of their Vanguard 10-foot extension cords and a 24-inch extension cord. And this stuff, you know, it all worked together. But here's the thing. This is going in this box. It's watertight-ish. Your mileage may vary. Please don't sue me because you got electrocuted because you didn't do what I did or you submerge this in a pool or something stupid like that. Just use your brain. This isn't a hard lift, people. It's just an easy fix for a problem that is just a first world problem. All right, so the Apache case comes with this really nice foam insert set of blocks. Unfortunately, we don't really need any of these. And in fact, I really don't want any of these. I'm not gonna store anything in here. This stuff's just gonna hang. This side here with the foam, that can actually come out too. I really don't want anything that's going to retain moisture. I just want the plastic box. The valve is cool. because, you know, this is going to sit latched nicely. It's going to sit latched with the Wemo box on the inside of it. The other thing is the plastic enclosure is nice because it's going to let the Wi-Fi flow like juice through the outside. If you use a metal enclosure, it might not work. Yeah, you could use a NEMA enclosure, I guess, but this is fine. I like the serviceability. I like the replaceability. I could take this apart. This burns up. It becomes damaged. I can replace it. I still have the case. So first things first, we're going to take off the plastic here. We'll keep the warning labels on. We'll keep the lawyers happy in the room. These cables can stay on here. That's fine. I don't care. All right. So anyway, we got the wrappers off. Clip this off. All right, so you just have a box and two extension cords and a Wemo unit.
I'm Wemo. Where's the Wemo? Hey, I'm a Wemo. Wemo.
So the basic idea is that you're going to have an extension cord here plug into your safe GFI grounded outlet. The opposing end of the cord is going to go up in, up into the box, not down into the box, up into the box, where the Wemo controller is going to plug in. So it gets its power, right? Then we're going to take the other end of the 24-inch cord here. We're going to plug that into the Wemo controller as the outlet, right? And then this whole thing is going to basically drip down out through the bottom so I can control three things with the Wemo controller safely in the box. When it rains, rain doesn't come in. There's a drip loop. Drip loop is a term for making sure water doesn't run into the box. It drips out by the cord. I think this is going to work. I don't really have a problem with this. It should actually work great. All right, let's see how it goes. Okay, so a couple things about the construction of this box. I got this box originally as some kind of toolkit for the motorcycle. I got it on sale. This is a better use for it. It'll make my family smile. This ridge right here is hard plastic. This ridge is soft plastic. I don't want to cut into the lid. I'm going to cut into the body of the box to make clearance for the two cords. Your mileage may vary. You could put some I may put some silicone caulk in here and just kind of call it. By the way, this is already hooked up to my Wi-Fi, the Wemo controller. So it should work pretty dandily. Not a hard lift here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this fancy tire crayon, white crayon, and I'm going to mark the plastic about there, a little dot there as well. This isn't rocket science. Now, I got people out there, hey, you should make a 3D model of it and then make a gasket. And you know what, dude? It's for my Christmas lights. Leave me alone. So my weapon of choice for this job will be a Milwaukee multi-tool Sonicrafter. See how it goes. Got a fairly fresh blade on here. Give it a shot. Turn it up to, I don't know, 6 sounds good. That there that way. That's a good way to get in there. Tell me, Jimmy, what should I do? I should measure the diameter of the wires with it. Yeah, it's right about there. All right, Jimmy, let's give this a shot here. Do a next pattern. That's a critical cut there. That cut, super important. You know, I could be a real jerk face and be like, oh, you have to measure this to this depth. I'm a big fan of the David Drell of Tattooing Mark III Forum. Measure nunce, cut once. Eyeball everything. So that was perfect because the fact is when I close the lid, oh, it snaps shut. And it pinches the cables oh so finely that they are relatively water resistant. And we're done! I have like waterproof housing with a Wi-Fi controller with an input and an output for multiple Christmas lights. Christmas is saved! Now here's the really cool thing about this case is that you can screw it. You can drill holes in the back here. Then you have locator holes. You could mount this nice and upright on the side of a siding or a pole or something. And now you have Wi-Fi. You have replaceable components. You have a fault with either one of these cords, you can replace them. You have a fault with the Wemo module, which you will not, you can replace it. It's not a package unit. You can fix this. You built it. Yeah. Go do that. Okay. So I have the box plugged in. Right there, sitting on the railing. It's not mounted. And it's plugged into my lights that go around the deck, which are Christmas lights, which are not on. I'm going to switch on the Wemo controller. And there we have it. Christmas lights on the deck, thanks to a box that's controlled by the internet, plugged into my house. Thanks for watching. Christmas in the bag, yo. Christmas in the bag.
Take that crazy Santa Claus with his red Rudolph. Take that walk that crazy.